people come to him, come to the way of Sultan Anbiya.
Thank you. JazakAllah. I thank you all the kids for showing your extreme love and affection. May Allah give you reward for this. And let's continue on in future life and future generations. Thank you very much. And also I thank the parents of these kids who have
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
تھوڑی سی آج دی بس میری آخری تو خدا ہے تو ہی عظیم ہے تو خدا ہے تو ہی عظیم ہے تیری
where
بدل الإسلام الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يكسب الإسلام. They act as they have done a great favor to Prophet. They are also the ones who يمنون عليك أن أسلم. The Prophet, they act as they have done a favor to you by becoming Muslim. And it says, قل لا تمنوا علي إسلامكم. Do not consider your Islam as a favor to my beloved. بل الله يمن عليه من هداه. Subhanallah's favor that he has given you this prophet, that the guidance is coming to you through this prophet. It is unfortunate that this greatest favor of a prophet is something which we ignore and we do not talk about it. And we talk very little about it, or we think somehow it is not as important as some other elements, like the politics of religion or the Sharia of religion. Here, of course, have value. But there is nothing more important than the person of Prophet, because whatever is there, whether it is the realm of creation or it is the realm of Hidayah, it is there through the single source and channel. And this channel of grace, in the channel of Hidayah, in the channel of Barakah, is the person of Prophet. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it is very important that we should understand that what is the nature of our relationship with the Prophet. In our contemporary discourse, we have many people who are always focused on Sharia, and they are never tired of reminding us that we have to follow everything to the smallest possible detail. And that is all what is there which we owe prophets and prophets. Of course, Sharia is an integral element of Islam, and nobody can disagree, and nobody can deny. But we should never forget that obedience and itaat is our response to the command. It is our response to the command, to the hukm. What is our response to the person of Prophet? What we owe him as a person, what we owe to the command is obedience. When command is given, whether it is given by Subhanallah wa ta'ala and the Prophet, then as a believer we obey. إِنَّمَا كَانَ خَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِلَىٰ تَرُوْهِ وَاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِّهِ أَنْ يَقُولُ سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. The response of a believer is to obey. But this response is to the command. What is my response to the person? What do I do to this being? If you ask a person, what is your relationship with your mother? If you ask a child, what is your relationship with your mother? And if he say that my relationship with my mother is that she has given me 10 rules which I follow, and this is my relationship, we will laugh at his answer. We will say, is this what your relationship is? The beginning of relationship, the foundation of relationship, the very first element is the ma'rifah of Prophet Muhammad. Who he is? We find in the literature of hadith that sometimes Prophet Muhammad will stand on the minbar and he will ask the companions, man ana, who am I? And then he will answer this question. And it is important to remember that if Prophet is asking them, who am I? Does he want to tell them that I am a human being, I am Bashar? Is this that he wants to tell them? Does he want to tell them that he is a prophet? Don't they know that he is a prophet? They know he is what does he tell them? He tells them about the dimensions and aspect of his being, which are infinite and unlimited, and which are hidden from human eyes. The Prophet stands in the mirror, and he will say that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created khalq, he split them in two, and he kept me in the best. When he split them in tribe, he kept me in the best. When he split them in families, he kept me in the best. I'll be the first one who will be raised. I'll be the first one who will do shafa'ah. I'll be the first one who shafa'ah will be accepted. So we find in this hadith literature that Prophet will tell us about his being before he was in this world, and about his being after he has physically left this world. So he will talk about the aspects and dimensions in which he is supernatural, in which he is beyond the realm of humanity, and his absolute true nature is beyond the comprehension of human suffering. As Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that my reality, my true inner substance is something which, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody knows. And this is the ma'rifa. Ma'rifa means to know who he is. And this is exactly what Quran demands when it talks either about God or it talks about the Prophet. Many times Quran will say, criticizing the companions, that they don't know God as he ought to be known. وَمَا قَدْرُ اللَّهَ حَقَ قَدْرِهِ. Because what is needed is not only the obedience of the command. What is needed is also to know who the God is. Do we really know him? This ma'rifa is an essential element of faith. This is an essential element of iman. And the ma'rifa of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that it is given to this whole universe, to the whole created all. As the beautiful recitation of Quran in the English we heard, Quran said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِّلْعَالَمِينَ. The Prophet did not send him, but mercy for whom? Not only for humans, not only for believers, but for any domain of existence, any alam which exists there. Prophet is mercy for that alam, for that universe, for that domain of existence. So the Prophet was known by all the domains of existence. By all the domains of existence. He was known even to stones. Prophet says in Sahih Muslim that there is a rock in Makkah. Even before I declared my nubuwwah, this rock used to say salam. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was 9 years old and he traveled with Abu Talib, and they stopped at a place in Syria, a monk, a Christian monk, when he saw this caravan coming, he came down. And the narrator says that the caravan, the trade caravans, have passed this route many times. And this person never came down and never came who this caravan is. But this time when Prophet was with us, as a child, as a 9-year-old child, he has not declared any Prophet but at that time, this monk comes down and he mingles with the people, and until he reaches to this child, he holds his hand and he says, this boy, he is Sayyid al-Alamin. He is the master of the universe. He is the Rahmatul Alameen.
And Abu Talib said that the Meccan chief minister asked him, how do you know? How do you know that this person is the Sayyidina Ali? And he said, when you were coming down, Tina Ashrafkum al Aqaba, لم يبقى شجر ولا حجر إلا خرسان. I saw you coming down this valley, and there was no tree and no stone, but it made Sayyidina Ali this person. ولا أسودان إلا النبي, and they don't make Sayyidina Ali anyone except the Prophet. As Khalid bin Sa'id had said this, the Prophet was only 9 years old. We find in the Hadith literature where the Prophet is known by stars, he is known by the mountains, he is known by the trees, he is known by the water, he is known by the dust, he is known by all kinds of animals. We find in Medina that the people will come to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they want him to cure their animals. Today, if you say this, people will say, Prophet's job is only to give us Sharia. He is not supposed to give us anything else. But we find a woman of Ansar comes and she says, oh Prophet, my camel, it has become mad and it has refused to work and it comes and attacks every person. The Prophet goes with this lady. And when he enters, the camel walks respectfully and puts his head on the feet of Prophet. And in fact, when Prophet enters the house, the woman warns Prophet and says, let O Prophet be very careful. This camel is mad and it attacks everyone. And Prophet says that yes, it does, but it will not do this to me. It will not do this to me, even though it is mad, but he is not that mad. So this camel has more wisdom than many of Muslims have today. That he refused, that we refuse to know who this Prophet is, but this camel knows. And when this camel comes, Prophet holds him his hand, puts on his head, and the camel is fine. The Prophet says, it's fine, we will work now. Now, the question comes, how does this camel know the Prophet? Because this camel attacks everybody. How does this camel know that this person is not an ordinary human being? And in fact, the book of Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he asked this question to Prophet, and how did this camel know? And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a statement here. He said, إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ شَيْءٌ بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُ أَنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. There is nothing in this universe between this earth and heavens, but it knows who I am. So this camel knows more than ulama or age. This is the marifah. This is the marifah. If the whole universe knows who this Prophet is, how it is possible that we should not know who he is? Or we should denigrate him? Or we should try to lower his status and then claim that if we exalt his status, it is some kind of bid'ah or shirk in this world. The statement is extremely fallacious in the accounts. Because the status which is exalted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no human can exalt more than that. To say that I can exalt the status of God, no human. How it is possible? How it is possible that we could do exaggeration in something which Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself has exalted beyond any knowledge. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, after Ma'rifah comes Muhabbah. The relationship of love with the person of Prophet that there is no one more beloved. And if Prophet is beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is beloved of the whole created all, then our love for him has to be extreme. It has to be utmost. May يكون الله ورسوله محبة إليه كما سبق. The sign of iman is that the love of Allah and His Prophet should exceed every other love which exists. Any other love which exists. One day, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sayyidina Umar were walking, and Prophet asked Sayyidina Umar, "How much do you love me?" Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu said that, "O Prophet, I love you more than anything else except my own son. I love you more than my family, my children, my love. But as for my own self is concerned, I really love more my own son."
I'm going to have to run off.
Prophet asked, "Does the moment of this is not acceptable?" This is not acceptable. Then Umar radiallahu anhu says, "O Prophet, I love you more than my own son." And Prophet said, "Umar, now you have iman's complete." Okay? So iman does not become complete unless the love of the Prophet is utmost. سَفِيلُ اللَّهُ مِنْ خَيْلِ الْبَرَايَا بِحُبِّكَ فِي الْقَالِ الْسَّحَابِ Sama Musa says, to God's chosen one, it is your love which creates the purity of our Aqeedah. Purity of Aqeedah would not be the love of Islam. A hadith of Hazrat Anas radiallahu anhu muttafaq alayhi hadith, he says, that one day we were sitting in the morning with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and a Bedouin came. And as he entered, he asked Prophet right away that, "O Prophet, let me be the doomsday. Let us stop." Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at him and he said, "Wama abadala." What did he prepare for this Qiyama that you are asking when did it come? Another thing is that the Badr was shocked with Prophet's answer. And then after a while he said that, "O Prophet, ma adantu laha ibara salaman wa la salatan wa la sadaqatin wa la kinti muhibbullah." Prophet, I did not do a lot of prayers and I did do a lot of fasting and a lot of charity, but I do love Allah and the Rasulullah. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "And the Ma'am, you will be with those whom you love." He could have said, "Go and pray more. Go and do more fasting." He did not say that. Prophet gave him the good news of being with him and the basis of the love which he had for Allah. So when we are deficient in our iman, and we are all deficient in our iman, we are all deficient. Our prayers, our fasting, they are never good enough to demand anything. Never good enough to demand anything. But the love compensates for this deficiency of our heart. But if we are deficient in love, then our heart do not compensate. One cannot say, "I don't love, but I am praying 100 rakah." Our heart do not degrees of Imam. People are at different degrees of Imam. But where a person is situated depends how much love he has for things. Then he says, Allah, La Imam wa Jumma Muhammad. Ya tafawad al Iman, ala qadr tafawadin fi mahabbati. Allah, La Imam wa Jumma Muhammad. It's three times. People are in different degrees of Allah. But where a person is situated depends how much love he has. So, dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in our relationship with Allah, of course, the obedience of Sunnah, the following of Allah is important. But before the Allah comes, Ma'rifah. If we don't know who the Prophet is, and if there is no love for him, then even 1,000 brothers will not save us. Because Allah alone will not bring salvation. What brings salvation is Allah, which are in the proper context of Ma'rifah and Ma'rifah. So never subhanahu wa ta'ala deepens this love in our heart. And extends our horizons to know who is God. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Rabbana Rabbina, the Adwara Guru Tami, Izaja Nakhil, 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 Nakhil,
Allah. inspired by the teaching you hear from Mawlana Hasan al-Jazar, from my Shaykh. It's about the love of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it has a salawat.
Allahumma
it's called the Tirakawa. Tirakawa.